I want to do this. I am want to. The spirit of compromise. I am going to share a vision given by the late Bob Jones concerning the Great Fall Away. The following is an allegorical experience continuing to convey certain principles essential for our development and training for the soon coming spiritual releases from heaven. In it, much prophetic symbolism is utilized to communicate prominent spiritual truths necessary to go on to the next level in the spirit. We do not attempt to define all meaning that can be derived from these experiences. Rather, we hope to accurately share the vision and its scriptural and historical foundations and ask the Holy Spirit to lead each reader to greater depths of understanding unique to their specific circumstances and level of maturity. The graveyard. In this vision, Bob and his wife were driving along the beautiful countryside. As the road continued, Bob found himself ascending a sizable hill that overlooked the villages surrounding this particular mountain. When he reached the summit and left his vehicle, he discovered that the top of the mountain was actually a graveyard of murdered women. The scene he observed communicated a violent and brutal scenario resulting in the death of those whose remains were evident on the burial ground. Upon closer scrutiny, Bob discovered these very Amazon women. Intuitively, he discerned these women to be representative of churches. Biblical prophecy often portrays churches as women. But in Bob's experiences, prophetic imagery is often used to convey a central theme or truth that the Holy Spirit is trying to communicate. The purpose of this message is to personify the churches as having been endowed with the dominant characteristics of the Amazon women as powerful, mighty warriors, victorious in battle. The church as portrayed in this revelation had been mightily anointed and had won great victories on behalf of their bridegroom. Even though these women were incredible warriors, something tragic had occurred to precipitate their demise. How could such a warlike clan end with such violence and uncertainty as characterized in the observed graveyard? Work in daylight before night cometh, in which no man can work. We must work the works of him who sent us as long as it is still day. Night is coming in which no man can work. John 9:4. The day is the proper time to work, night is not. This is a decree in God's word. While the day lasts, it is proper to labor. Unfortunately, these women did not follow the admonition to do the work during the daylight hours and find rest that night. Instead, they had ventured out in the day hours and entered into promiscuity. They had grown weary waiting upon their bridegroom to fulfill his promises to her. Unwisely, they had joined themselves to men whose initial appearance seemed good and beneficial, but whose hearts were evil, eventually murdering these women when they least expected it. However, the big question remained. What led them to such unadvisable decision? With this revelation, Bob began to examine the top of the mountain more closely and noticed that many of the skeletons were openly displayed as trophies without being buried. Several skulls and skeletons were evident on the surface of the mountains, as tokens and reminders of the great error made by the Amazon women. The scene was indeed ugly and undesirable. Bob decided to depart from this scene immediately. But before he could do so, a very fast-talking man approached him. This fast-talking man had the confidence and assurance of a professional salesman. He was also very adept in convincing. He explicitly displayed the mastery of communication and flattery and could easily deceive with this gift. Immediately, Bob asked this man his identity. The man responded, identifying himself as Compromise. It was Mr. Compromise who was responsible for the death of these once powerful women. Some verses which came to Bob were the following: "But the Spirit explicitly says that in the last times, some will fall away from the faith, giving attention to deceiving, seducing spirits and doctrines of demons, by means of the hypocrisy of liars, whose consciences have been seared as with a hot iron." 1 Timothy 4:1-2. Despite the powerful attributes of the women and the victories they had gained, their strength was no match for Mr. Compromise. Compromise will always destroy the most powerful of warriors. Samson was the most anointed man of his day, yet compromise in one small area of his life cost him the anointing and the many victories that could have been achieved had he remained faithful. Some will fall away from the faith, paying attention to deceitful spirits and doctrines of demons. It was the Lord's great grace that restored Samson in the end and allowed one final victory over the enemy. However, it would have remained a much greater testimony had he remained faithful to the end and not giving any place to compromise. Inconceivable as it may seem at first, this was the same bold form the enemy embodied the idea of trapping the Lord Jesus with a spirit of compromise at the outset of his ministry. It was an appeal to the holy purpose for which the Lord came to earth, so that good might result. Satan offered the kingdoms of this world to the Lord through an unholy alliance and compromise of the plan of God. The kingdom is to be won, but in the way ordained by God and in the manner foretold in Scripture. Compromise will claim to carry us to the goal we to achieve in a way that seems expedient and convenient, but the end way is destruction. There is a way that seems right unto a man, but the end way is death. Proverbs 14:12. The death of compromise. When Mr. Compromise realized that Bob had seen the graveyard of the Amazon women, and intended to carry the warning to the church of this generation, he immediately took Viola, Bob's wife, by the arm, and threatened to destroy her if Bob shared what he had seen. It is important to recognize this as spiritual symbolism and not as a personal threat. Bob's wife is representative of the church in this prophetic experience. Was this threat? A godly jealousy and righteous anger arose in Bob's heart against compromise for placing his hand against Viola, the church. The MSN brazenly responded there was nothing Bob could do about it as he had no weapon. What compromise did not know was that Bob had a knife strategically placed up his sleeve. This knife was easily accessible in hand-to-hand combat. This knife represented the Word of God in his spirit. Let the Word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom. Colossians 3:16. Was this discovery? Bob confidently walked towards compromise and took hold of the trench knife and buried it deep in the heart of compromise. It was compromise that caused the death of the Amazon women, the churches, and the authority from God's word was placed in Bob's hand to destroy this life-threatening spirit. By grace, the Lord is releasing to this generation the wisdom and authority to identify and defeat this great enemy of the church. This victory is assured if we are willing to obediently heed the voice of the Spirit and do the will of the Father. Faithful adherence to the Word of God will always bring death to the spirit of compromise. Lessons from the Bible. Instead of being in their responsible positions and loyal to the bridegroom, the Amazon women allowed a spirit of compromise to deceive them in unlawful relationship. Rather than being at home devoting themselves to their husbands, they were entering a promiscuous relationship with other men. Behold, I will throw her and those who commit adultery will into great tribulation unless they repent of their deeds. And I will kill her children with pestilence, and all the churches will know that I am he who searched the minds and hearts, and I will give each one according to your deeds. Revelation 2:22-23. The Lord is to be the husband of the church, and relationship with man that will usurp the rightful position of the Lord as bridegroom is considered spiritual adultery. The spirit of compromise would always try to convince the people of God to relinquish their promised heritage in a covenant relationship and follow a counterfeit relationship which seems appropriate at the time. That was the teaching of the prophet Balsamic to cause the Israelites to compromise with surrounding people of Moab, and that brought about the judgment of God. And Moses said to them, "Have you spared all the women? Behold, these cause the sons of Israel, through the counsel of Balaam, to trespass against the Lord in the manner of Peor. So the plague was among the congregation of the Lord. Now therefore kill every male among the little ones, and kill every woman who has known man intimately. But all the girls who have not man intimately spare for yourselves." Numbers 32:15-18. Our duties toward our bridegroom are of separation and purity, patiently waiting on the promised unity with the Lord Jesus. It is the counsel of compromise to lead us away from our unity with our bridegroom. What is the way of Balaam? It is the covetously conduct of the little ones, described in the scriptures as hirelings, whose primarily motivated is to commercialize their divine gifting. Forsaking the right way, they have gone astray, having followed the way of Balaam, the son of Beor, who loved the wages of unrighteousness. 2 Peter 2:15. The teaching of Balaam is the teaching of the mercenary ministry, counseling the church to abandon godly separation and noble character in favor of worldly conformity. "But I have a few things against you, because you have some there who hold the teaching of Balaam, who kept teaching Balak to put a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols and to commit sexual immorality." Revelation 2:14. Very often following this path will seemingly bring will quick results and momentary pleasures. There is also not much spiritual resistance in this way. Nevertheless, the fruit after all these things is spiritual death and fruitlessness. The only hope for victory was to corrupt them with YHR seduction of the world. Balaam taught Balak to corrupt people who could not be cursed by seducing them to marry Moabite women and so commit spiritual adultery. That is the motivation of compromise as outlined in Bob's vision. The enemy could not conquer the Amazon women in battle, therefore the only hope for victory was to corrupt them with the spirit of the world. Now we have received, not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, so that we may know the things given to us by God. 1 Corinthians 2:12. If the Amazon women had remained at their abode, as was their initial responsibility, they would have become fruitful and productive, bearing more children necessary to maintain their way of life. Because they allowed compromise to deceive them, their lives were ended and their children were left to be raised as orphans in an unsupervised manner. The Lord is desiring women churches to be loyal to their husband and to be abundantly fruitful. Producing offspring to the glory of God. Psalm 128. Compromise will always lead us into wrong relationships which lead to death. Faithfulness leads to repentance, answered prayer and victory. Even though the wait hours seem long and tedious, and lonesome, it would be compromise to depart from that place of responsibility and enter relationships leading to our demise and spiritual death away from our bridegroom. With those conclusions, Bob departed from the mountain, reality the destructive qualities of compromise. A glorious future. The most grievous aspect of the vision was the great future forfeited by the powerful women churches as illustrated here. Even though they had been victorious and productive, their most rewarding years lay ahead of them if they could have overcome the deceptions of compromise. These churches had been powerfully anointed, fruitful warriors of the faith. The enemy was able to destroy them during the long tarrying hours. If the women had remained in their post of duty, they would not have been taught captive by the spirit of compromise to do his will. Compromise begins in the soul of man what can be described as the thought realm. This is why we are commanded to bring every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. All of the strongholds of the enemy are designed to obscure our knowledge of God and his thoughts and ways. When our vision of the race has been impaired and blinded, alternative courses are introduced that will seemingly take us to our desired destination but are not the thoughts and ways of God. We must not be prepared to give an inch of our commitment to the enemy, otherwise he becomes a ruthless ruler. Through this prophetic analogy, the women lost their first love and compromised their chastity to follow men whom perceived would make them more fruitful and productive. In reality, their decision cost them their lives. Our battlefield is in the souls of men, where our mind, will emotions reside. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal but mighty in God in pulling down strongholds and fortresses that the enemy has erected. We have to take captive every thought into obedience to Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 10:4, 5. Compromising to bring unity, compromising the calling and commission of God and the true revelation of his word, for a false unity, results only in spiritual death. A man named Compromise that Bob met in the vision, was a great orator with a superb command of language, with the ability to convince others of his unsanctified agenda. Compromise's aim was to compromise the anointed church into a pseudo-unity around the precepts of men rather than a true revelation of God's word. Our determination in this regard should be God's way or no way. We must patiently wait for God's way to be revealed without yielding to the temptations of compromise. Amen.